हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, विशिंग यू ऑल आर गुड एंड डूइंग वेल एट होम। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द स्पीच प्रोनाउन एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन दैट वीडियो द पर्सनल प्रोनाउन एंड इंटरोगेटिव प्रोनाउन। सो नेक्स्ट थर्ड टाइप ऑफ द प्रोनाउन इज द डेमोंस्ट्रेटिव प्रोनाउन। इट मीन्स demonstrative pronoun is used to point out a object ki when we want to point out object we use the demonstrative pronoun। This, that, these, those are used to point out the object। This and that we are using as a singular form। The things that is very near in singular, then we are using this, and anything that is very far but in the form of the singular, then we are using that demonstrative pronoun। Same in case of these and those, these we are using for nearer but in the form of the plural, those we are using for farther but in the form of the plural object। So in other words, we can say this and that we will use things at hand or very nearby। Okay, clear ki things at hand or very nearby, and same in case of these and those, things like at a distance or very far। Okay, a distance or very far। Now see the example, here is already example is given। This is my pen, that is your house, those are his pens। So you can differentiate at here, this is my pen, my pen means singular thing, this we are using, that is your house, house is for, on distance, then we are using that, those are his pens, pens is given, noun is given in the form of the plural, object is given in the form of the plural, so that's why what we are using here, those। Okay, so this is a demonstrative pronoun। Now the next type of the pronoun is possessive pronoun। Possessive pronoun, a pronoun that shows possession is called a possessive pronoun। Okay, कि a pronoun that shows a possession is called a possessive pronoun। Possession means ownership, कि when the noun is the owner of anything else, in simple form we can say। Okay, possessive pronoun means a pronoun that shows possession is called a possessive pronoun। Another simple word we can say कि when the noun is the owner of anything is known as the possessive pronoun। For example, this shirt is mine, so here mine is a possessive pronoun। ठीक है, possessive pronoun। I gave him my pen, he has lost his। I gave him my pen, here my is a adjective, my is a possessive adjective, but he has lost his, he has lost his is a possessive pronoun। Why my is adjective? Because we are using it with noun। Okay, we know it very well, that pronoun which we used in place of noun। Okay, we bought this house, it is ours, so here ours is a possessive pronoun। That doll is hers, clear? So in our English grammar, I have already discussed in the previous video, mine, our, your, his, her, theirs and its, these are the possessive pronoun which we are using in our English grammar, okay, as a possessive pronoun। Now very important point about this, so let's start to discuss ki what are the important point regarding to this। So important point ki your, mine, hers, his, our, theirs, so these do not theirs, ठीक है, so do not qualify the nouns, ये qualify नहीं करते हैं noun को। They shows the possession and here these have been used in place of noun। I have already discussed, sometime in possessive pronoun are used with of also, because of preposition word we are also using for showing the possession, especially with the non-living object. Okay, now he is the friend of mine. He is a friend of mine. We are using of with mine. That dog of yours often barks at night. So sometime we are using of preposition with possession also. Next is mine, your, his, her, are, their. Are possessive adjective, and these words are used to indicate possession, but these are used with the noun. Okay, example, my dog, your book, his pen, etc. Now the next kind of the pronoun is distributive pronoun. Distributive pronoun means distribute. What is the meaning of distributive pronoun? Distribute. It means refers to person or things one at a time. Okay? Refers to, distributive pronoun refers to person or a thing, but one at a time. Now the pronoun here, pronouns, then we will use always singular verb. In the verb we will always, with distributive pronoun we will always use the singular verb, and here is each, either, and neither are used as a distributive pronoun. We will use each, either, and neither. Either or either, neither or neither are used as a distributive pronoun. So see the example and then differentiate it. Each refers to two or more person. Okay, each refers to two or more person taken one by one. Example, each of you gets a prize. Each comes forward in his turn. Clear? He refers to two or more person, but taken one by one. That's why we are using singular verb with distributive, singular verb with distributive pronouns. Second is either. It has two meanings, either one or the other. Second is each of the two or both. So example, ki either of you may go to shop. Either of the two roads leads to the bus stand. So try to understand it with the help of these two examples. Either of you may go to shop. Okay, one or the other. Either of you. Either of the two roads leads to the bus stand. Now same like this, next is neither or neither. It means not the one nor the other of the two. Means equivalent to, it is equivalent to nothing, negation form. Okay, means not the one nor the other of the two. Example, neither of you come in time. Clear? Neither of you come in time. Right? So this is the distributive pronoun, and each, either, and neither we are using as a distributive pronoun. Okay, so next type of the pronoun is relative pronoun. That is very important type of the pronoun. So let's start to discuss the relative pronoun. It joins sentences and refer to nouns which go before them. Okay, what is a relative? Relative means relative, relation. It joins the sentences, it joins the clauses. And refers to noun which go before them. Means, and which relative pronoun we will use, it depend upon the noun, or it refers to the noun which go before them. Okay, so again at here, relative pronouns are who, whose, whom, that, and which. These are the five common relative pronoun which we are using at present. We are using whoever, whatever, these are also, but these are the main. Okay, who, whose, whom, that, and which. So now again try to understand it with the help of the given table. You can see here one table is given. Relative pronoun are who, whose, whom, that, and which. Now pronoun, who, who we are using only for persons, only for person. As a subjective, in case of we are using who, as a possession, okay, then we are using whose, and as a objective we are using who, but only in case of person. Second is which, animal or object only, animals or object only, because with person we are already using who, which. Now as a subject is which, as a possessive of which, and as a object we are also using it as a which. Third is your that, for things, persons and animal. Okay, so that we can use for things, for person, for animal also, and sometimes we can also that as a definitely clause. Okay, we can also use this relative clause, relative pronoun, as to make the definitely clause, then we can also use it. Second very important point that we should remember, that is also used before the superlative degree or adjective. Okay, that is also used before the superlative degree of adjective. Okay, so here you can see things, for things we will only use what as a subjective, as a objective, as a possessive. Okay, now here is example is given, so try to understand it with the help of the example. He is the noblest man. Okay, okay, that is also used after, sorry, not before but after, after the superlative degree of the adjective. He is the noblest man that I have ever seen. This is the boy that won the first prize. Now see the example, now related to adjective, related to relative clause, and try to identify it. See, here is example given. Ram is a man who can be trusted, yeah, who can be trusted. Okay, so here Ram is a man, so you can see what is the subject here, man, person. Then which relative pronoun we are using to join the two sentences, who. Second, Anil is a boy whom everybody likes. Now Anil is a boy, object boy, who. I gave the book to the boy whose one leg is broken, jiski. I gave the book to the boy, okay, the owner of the book. The pen which I had lost was very beautiful. Okay, now next, the dog which barked at us was not a mad dog. Animals which listen to what the teacher say. Okay, listen to what the teacher say. So these are the examples of the relative pronoun. Okay, so today we will discuss up to here. Next part of the pronoun, next kind of the pronoun, we will discuss in the next video. Thank you. Have a good day.